This is the klystron power supply with reference to the klystron setup bench. This is the klystron power supply. From there to it goes to the klystron mount. This is called the klystron mount. And this is the klystron oscillator, or it is called the klystron tube. From there to according block diagram, next component we are connected to the isolator. In isolator, one way power is going. That is, this is as a one, this is as a two output port, and our third port we are connecting to the match termination. This has a fixed load. And third component, according to the block diagram, we are connecting to the variable attenuator. This is a variable point. Here this is the input, this is the output in the variable attenuator. After this component, we are connecting to the variable, we are going to connect to the frequency meter. This is the variable frequency meter. Here we can measure frequency from 8.2 to 12.4 gigahertz. And after that we are connecting to the detector mount. This is that component. From this output we are connecting to the VSWR meter. This is without any load, common bench setup is like this. This is the VSWR meter. Here we are taking the parameters in dB scale or SWR scale. And according experimental procedure, we are connecting different ports. This is called the directional coupler. Here there is a four ports are here. One is input port, first port, second port, third port, and fourth port. This fourth port is the fixed match termination. This load is called the directional coupler. This is one of the experiment. And another one, this is the magictee or EHT. It is called a EHT or magictee. This is the, here there is a port 1, port 2, E port and H port. Here there is a four ports are here. This is another experiment. With the help of this we can do a EHT experiment. And this is the three port circulator. Here one port acts as an input port, and one port acts as an output port, and third port we are going to connect as a match termination as a fixed load. We circulate ports from 1-2-2, 2-2-3 and 3-2-1. And this is the horn antenna. And this is called the variable shot. This is the match termination. In circulator component, this has a port 1 component. Port 1 has an input. And this has a port 2. And third port, this is output port, actually port 2. And third port has a fixed match termination is there. And this is the variable shot. This component is the variable shot. And this component is a horn antenna. With the help of these loads, we are going to do the experiments in this lab. One by one, I am going to explain. Now I am going to start to set up this bench from mount onwards. Now this is the klystron mount with oscillator. From here onwards, you start from the, now we are going to connect to the oscillator and see the proper direction, rectangle to rectangle, hole must be matched. Don't put like this, you put it like this. Diagonally, we are going to fix it two screws. Now isolator I am connecting towards to the input of the isolator. I am connecting the klystron mount with oscillator. And klystron, this isolator second port I am going to connect to the variable attenuator. This is the variable attenuator. Here also I am going to connect with the two screws diagonally. You fix it properly without any gap. Otherwise power loss is there. Fix it properly without any gap from one component to other component. Without any gap, we fix it like this. And this alternator output we connect generally. If you are measuring frequencies in experiment, you connect the variable frequency meter. Otherwise, you set it to, you connect direct to the detector mount. Here also you fix it to your output load detector mount properly without any gap. And from here to you connect one BNC probe, this output to VSWR meter. Now use it to your stands properly. One stand you keep it under the klystron mount. Another stand you connect to the variable alternator and take it one more stand to the detector, waveguide detector. And here you connect the match termination towards isolator. Isolator with match termination. This also you cannot without any gap. Now all the components I connect without any gap. See, now one by one I am going to explain. Klystron power supply, then klystron oscillator, klystron mount, and this I connect to the klystron mount to isolator input and with match termination. Isolator output we are connected to the VA input side, and VA output I am connected to the waveguide or detector mount. This output goes to the VSWR meter. Actually diode is here in this, but I can show you diode component. This is the 1 and 2, 3 detector diode. This is the diode. Detector diode 1 and 2, 3. This output connected to the SWR meter through the probe, PNC probe. This is the general setup for any experiment without your load. You are supposed to connect your bench like this and you switch on your waving fan.
First, once again, we explain from here. First,
you start from klystron power supply. Klystron power supply to
this connection goes to
the klystron oscillator, and this oscillator fixed on the klystron mount.
Okay.
And this is the isolator. Isolator output we are connected to the variable and attenuator. Isolator is fixed with the match termination here. Isolator output connected to the variable attenuator. Variable attenuator output we are connected to the waveguide or detector mount. This output.
How many parts like that?
This is the general setup.
Okay.
Any experiment without your procedural load, you set it the bench like this and you set your voltages reference levels at 0 dB. After that, according to your procedure, you can see the power in the dB scales. Without connecting any procedural load, your initial setup is like this.
For basic setup, how many parts here? First one,
five components are here. Six components.
Second stage, third stage, fourth stage.
Six components are here.
Yeah.
In this bench, six components are there. One is the, actually starts from klystron power supply. That is the one component. And then klystron oscillator, klystron mount, isolator with match determination, variable attenuator, and attenuator or detector mount. From then, this output, this is the BNC probe, this output we are taking with the help of BNC probe, we are connected to the SWR meter. Results we can see here only in the SWR meter. That here there is a four scales are here. VSWR 1, expand VSWR, 0 to 10 dB scale is there, expand dB scale is there. Generally we see the dB scale, dB power only.
One more one.
And I will explain, now I will explain the power supply.
Okay.
In the power supply, in front panel you see, in the power supply here, different modes are there. External modulation mode, frequency modulation mode, amplitude modulation mode, continuous wave modulation mode is there. Generally, when you do, depend upon the experiment, these modes we are going to select. This is the expand bench. Most of the experiments we are selected at the AM modulation. Any frequency effect is not there, that is AM effect is not there, at that time we select in continuous wave mode. When frequency modulation or amplitude effect is there, we must select in the amplitude modulation. One or two experiments is there in this lab, that is the klystron mode chacterstics and gundiode chacterstics is there. In some section of experiments, we are selected to the continuous wave mode. When you select the continuous wave mode, there is no modulation amplitude and frequency effect is not there in the bench. Okay, and second thing, this is the FM. FM generally in expand range in this lab for this experiments we are not using. You can keep it anywhere, this knobs, frequency or amplitude of the FM, better to keep it minimum when you are not using. And when you select AM modulation, AM frequency and amplitude knobs, better to keep it at maximum side. And this is the beam voltage, initially keep it beam voltage at minimum before switch on your power supply. And repeller voltage before switch on your power supply, keep it at maximum position. And this is the selector display for the voltage display of the beam voltage, V for the voltage display and C for the current, and REP mean repeller voltage, and this is the selector display at off position. This is the standby position switch, off on switch is here. Okay, at back side of this output we can see at back side. This output is goes to the klystron oscillator. This is the power supply input of the klystron supply. 230 volts we are connected here. This is the klystron power supply front panel. And this is the output, this is the input of the experiment, and output readings we are going to see in VSWR meter. And this is the VSWR meter input. Experiment output to we are connecting as the input of the SWR meter. Here you see the off on switch is here, and this is a crystal mode, low and high is there. Generally you select in crystal mode only, and SWR powers 0 to 60 dB scales are there. In each range 10 dB it is increasing, and this course and gain always equipped at maximum position, course and gain control knobs, normal and expand is there. Particularly these two ranges here, this is related with the scale, display scale. Here normal range mean VSWR normal scale is here. You see 1 to infinity is the normal scale of the VSWR, and dB scale 0 to 10 dB is there. That is the normal range of the power. And expand positions already clearly mentioned here on front panel. You see from 1.32 this scale is there, expand. And expand dB scale is there. At that time you suppose to keep it at expand mode. Otherwise it is always at normal. Generally in this lab we are taking in normal mode only. Okay. See, this is the description of the microwave bench block diagram and reflexklystron block diagram. In a hard copy, we give a manuals. For this 10 experiments, we prepared one manual. In that, everything is there. Description of the microbench setup and reflexklystron oscillator block diagram. And the theory part also, we are providing the manual part. And let us start now first experiment, circulator and isolator experiment. Like this, we prepare our manuals. Now let us start for the one experiment, that is the circulator or isolator, circulator and isolator. Now first we switch on your baby fan and properly project to this fan towards to the klystron oscillator. Otherwise, when proper temperature is not maintained, in oscillator frequencies are going to disturb. And now we are going to switch on. Before switch on your power supply, we check it your klystron, this mode, power supply mode, you select in AM mode. And AM frequency and amplitude, you keep it maximum. Beam voltage minimum, repeller, you keep it maximum. And this you selected beam voltage position. And switch on your power supply. And simultaneously switch on your SWR meter also. And this better to select at mid-range 30 dB or 40 dB as you like. Depend upon your output power. And coarse and fine control, you keep it maximum, select in normal mode and crystal mode. Now your beam voltage, you are observing in the power supply 244 volts. You are supposed to keep it 300 volts beam voltage. Now you vary the beam voltage and increase and set it properly at 300 volts. You gently vary and set it 300. Is not much difference. Okay, now it is 300 volts. Now I select the SWR meter at 30 dB scale. Then VA, little bit I open. Don't complete close it, this variable attenuator, little bit I open. Then only power goes to the your klystron detector. Waveguide detector. And now you do the tuning in the bench. You start from the repeller voltage. You gently decrease the repeller voltage from maximum to minimum. Now you see the maximum position repeller voltage at 250 volts. This is the repeller voltage. And current milliamps. And beam voltage around 300 volts. This is the power supply position. Now we do the tuning from repeller voltage onwards. See, when I am decreasing the repeller voltage, you see the SWR readings. There is a deflection in the SWR, you can see. This is the first deflection. You see the dB scale from 0 to 10 dB scale. You observe the 0 to 10 dB scale. And when I operate the repeller voltage from maximum to when I am decreasing, you can see a deflection towards 0 where it goes maximum. That is the first deflection. If continuously I am decreasing, second deflection also, you can see. 1 minute. I am going to keep it in repeller voltage at 251 volts. See, here you cannot see any deflection in the SWR meter. When I am reducing the repeller voltage, you can see the first deflection at 229 volts. First deflection at 229 volts. And second deflection, again it's come back to minimum. And second deflection, you can see maximum deflection at 169 volts. This is the second deflection. And third deflection, again it's going to minimum. And third deflection we are going to see at 123 volts. At 123 volts. and fourth deflection also you can see at 104. Like that you can see 5-6 times deflections. But according to your procedure, you are supposed to set your bench at higher deflection where you observe in the repeller voltage. Higher deflection where now maximum repeller voltage at 251 volts. When you decrease this, first deflection where you observe, that is the tuning of the repeller voltage setup. You see in the SWR 2-0 where it goes to maximum, that is the proper tuning of the repeller voltage. This is the proper tuning of the repeller voltage. 251 is the maximum, there you cannot see any deflection in the SWR meter. At 2 volts, you can see the maximum deflection in the SWR meter. There you leave it the repeller voltage knob. That is the proper tuning of the repeller voltage. That is the maximum repeller voltage side is there. After that, you go for the modulation frequency. This is right now in maximum position. Gently I am decreasing. See, deflection you observe in SWR, where you got the maximum deflection towards zero. See, this is the less. Again you go and do the tuning towards zero. This is towards zero. This is the position for the modulation frequency. There you leave it that now. And go for the amplitude. This is a better position, maximum, there it will. You keep it like this. 2-0, where you got, there is it, you set it. To check it, your beam voltage, 298. Okay, 299, it's okay. Now, you see, towards maximum, it is there, all the three. At zero, this also at zero maximum, and repeller also at maximum. If it is beyond 0 dB, with the help of variable attenuator, you set it exact 0 dB. See this effect, you can see variable effect in the SWR meter. At 0 dB. This is the proper tuning in the bench. With the help of repeller voltage, modulation frequency and modulation amplitude, and with the help of finally variable attenuator, we set it at 0 dB in 30 dB scale. In 30 dB scale without our procedural load, we set it at 0 dB. This is the initial tuning in the bench. Now we are not connected any load in the bench. Our reference in 30 dB, SWR scale 0, we set it. Don't touch this when you set the reference like this by doing the tuning. Don't touch the repeller voltage, frequency, AM frequency now, or AM amplitude now, or beam voltage. Don't vary it. Now according to your procedure, now we are going to start the isolator experiment. See, this is the block diagram and procedure also there in write-up. And simultaneously we can do the circulator also. This is the circulator block diagram. 3-port circulator is there. Now I am going to show that components. See, this is the 3-port circulator. This is the 3-port circulator. There is the 3 ports are there. Port 1, this is port 1, this is port 2 and this is port 3. One as a input, two as a output, or two as a input, one as a output, that is called an isolator.
How can you find out which is 1-1, which is 2, which is 3?
That is when power is going from after variable attenuator, 1 to 2 is power is going, that is the 1 you can detect and 2 like that we can detect. And 2 as a input, 1 as a output, power cannot go in isolator part. Okay. Like that by doing the experiment we can find that. And 1 as an input, 2 as output. Here we marked already by doing the experiment, we find this as a port 1, port 2 and port 3. 1-2-2, 2-2-1, if you are taking the readings, it is called the isolator. If you circulate this port, port 1 as an input, port 2 as output, port 3 has a match termination. If you fix it like this, this is called a circulator. Port 1 has an input, port 2 has an output, port 3. Like that, if you change the inputs, all the 3 ports, that is called a circulator. And we can see, I will show the tabular column for circulator. For the circulator experiment, according to this tabular column, we are following, you see that component. This is the component, and check your tabular column. Here, input port, port 1 is there. These are all the input ports. And this is the matched ports. Matched mean that load. This is the matched termination. And output port mean your waveguide. This component. Anyway, we are going to start the experiment. Now I am going to remove the output. You see properly now, before removing the waveguide, our setup at 0 dB in 30 dB scale. Now I am removing the waveguide. Detector mount, and according to this tabular column procedure, is check it now. When I am removing the load, output detector mount, it goes back to minimum. Now I am going to connect to the load. This is the circulator. Port 1 has an input. According procedure, port 1 has an input. Input mean here is supposed to connect the input, and port match termination, port 3 is the matched, we connect at port 3. This is the match termination, and 3 is the proper hole matching. And put like this. Nice in 3-port circulator component. And now port 3 is the match termination, and port 2 is the output. This is the port 2. Now I am going to connect to the port 2 match termination. This port 2 I connect to the detector mount. Now fix it properly. Port 3 has a match, port 2 has a output without any gap, and I am using these two stands diagonally at output side with the help of stand support. I am taking input port at 1, input port at 1.
This is load.
One this is load. In this load, input has 1,
okay.
Output has 2, okay. And third port I am connected to the match load.
Second one connected to
output.
Output.
First one we are connected to the input.
Okay.
Input of the isolator.
Okay.
And output of the attenuator.
And every part we must fix only at least two screws.
Yes, at least minimum 2 screws. Better without any gap, you are supposed to connect four screws, but for our convenience we can fix it 2 screws diagonally and fix it properly without any gap. Now you see port 1 without any gap is there, port 2 also without any gap. This is the output port, this is the matched port is the fixed port here in third port. Now you see the reading.
Delete, sir. This is correct. Zero.
That's awesome.
Delete.